Hello and welcome, fifth grade scholars, as we celebrate you and your moving up to middle school. Also welcome to parents and families near and far, as well as our NOVA community. Before we would begin, I would like to take a moment to thank the people who helped you make it to where you are today. Parents and families, thank you for the love, encouragement, and support you have given your children during the elementary years. Pre-K through fifth grade teachers, thank you for your expertise, energy, and devotion to children's learning and development. At every grade level, students at NOVA International School are nurtured and valued by our incredible group of educators. As a special thanks to the fifth grade teachers who have guided this class through this year, and know that this group is ready to move on to face the challenges of middle school. Fifth graders, it was an honor getting to know you this year. This was a special year when you were finally the oldest students and leaders in the elementary school. Each of you stepped into this role in your own way and made your unique contributions. You have challenged and supported each other, had some great laughs and fun times, and made some mistakes and hopefully learned from them, and developed a hearty sense of self through hard work and perseverance. I saw the impact of your kindness in the community service projects you initiated and participated in that not only helped humans, but also animals. You showed the younger students that showing how much you care about your school and community through your actions make a difference. I watched you grow academically throughout the year. Each of you has deepened your knowledge and topics and concepts that were introduced in earlier grades. You have developed a more sophisticated understanding of literature and language, learned more complex math, and worked collaboratively on IPC units that integrated science and social studies concepts. The Atomic Dance was certainly a highlight where you incorporated science, song, and dance. I think we all learned more about protons, neutrons, and electrons from you. In elementary school, each of you has had a glimpse of your potential as a student, an artist, an athlete, a musician, a dancer, a scientist, and above all, a friend. My wish for you as you forge your path into middle school is that you continue to develop your potential and grow into courageous learners and young people who will change the world. We all hope you have fond memories of your elementary years. These years have been rich in traditions, people, experiences, stories, and laughs that have helped shape the dynamic, wonderful class that you are. We are proud of you for the fantastic work you've done, and congratulations on moving up to the next chapter of your life in middle school.
Stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll tell the world to find you. And if you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light there to guide you. We find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me, like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. 'Cause I know when I need it, I can count on you, like 4, 3, 2, you'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Ooh, ooh, yeah.
this academic year, we have planted the seeds for inquiry-based learning so that our fifth graders can continue with this type of learning into their MYP years. Inquiry-based learning generates such excitement in students that their brain electricity is on high power, dendrites on alert, and they can't wait to become experts in answering their own questions. Once the investigation journey begins, students research from a variety of sources, expressing their unique creativity, and finally, they take pride and ownership of their work. Students who are inquirers are brave young people with zest for learning who are not afraid of asking questions and making errors. They develop problem-solving skills and they develop lots of critical thinking skills. So, my dear inquirers, never stop questioning and don't be afraid of errors. Instead, learn from them. Remember what Nikola Tesla once said, "I have not failed. I have just found 10,000 ways that won't work." So, I'm very curious to find out, what is your favorite inquiry-based learning from this school year?
I've used inquiry-based learning in IPC and Reading Language and Arts. Three examples of how I use inquiry-based learning are: in the IPC unit, Bake It, my grandma taught my team how to make Macedonian traditional pita. The second example is in the IPC unit, the human body. I researched the effects of COVID-19 on the human body. And the third and last reason is in the Maya civilization. I used my trip to Chichen Itza to answer many different questions and help me in the IPC unit.
My favorite inquiry-based learning was about the Mayan civilization because there was like a lot of things for me, I was thinking about a lot of questions like the Mayan calendar or the how they sacrificed blood to the gods how they declined and how they rose and how they become the most powerful civilization in the world.
I applied inquiry-based learning in the unit Being Human when I asked a question and made further research on the question. For example, the question I asked was, what causes high blood pressure? I had to research a lot of sub-questions, such as how do you know you have high blood pressure? What are the causes and symptoms? How can you lower blood pressure and the treatment? We had to cite all of our sources in order to be academically honest. It was a fun and interesting experience, so that's why I chose it for my favorite inquiry-based learning in fifth grade.
Inquiry-based learning starts with an open-ended question. At the beginning, we started with a guided inquiry where we had Ms. Babich's support. Then we started with an open inquiry where we got to ask our own questions about the topic, which was IPC human being unit. And my question was, what are the benefits of sports to the body and its systems and organs?
My favorite inquiry-based project is the one where I researched about Madagascar. Here are some interesting facts about Madagascar. Madagascar is the world's fourth largest country island after Greenland, New Guinea, and Borneo. Madagascar, island country lying off the southeastern coast of Africa.
By doing one of my music assignments, I learned that Joseph Haydn composed the German national anthem.
So this year we provided inquiry-based learning on Bake It Unit. That's one of the projects I choose because I learned a lot about different stuff to bake and a lot of stuff that I could use to bake, and we tasted different foods, and yeah.
Me and my classmates used inquiry-based learning throughout the whole year. My favorite unit that we used inquiry-based learning was the Being Human unit. It was my favorite unit because we got to research a lot and we got to study about the human body. But most of all, my favorite reason was that we connected reading, language and arts with IPC.
This is my speech for inquiry-based learning. Throughout the year with Ms. Babbage, we have been using inquiry-based learning in every unit. But if I had to pick my favorite, it would be Bake It, because we used live experiments and that helped us better understand the process. A few inquiry questions I asked along the way were, what will happen if I add burnt water and sugar to the yeast? What is froth? What's inside an atom? What is the density of a nucleus? And what's the difference between physical and chemical change? Ms. Babbage is one of the best teachers me and my class had, and I think it's unfair that our year with her was cut in half.
Most of the IPC projects that we do in fifth grade are similar to experiments. We have a question, and the next class we research and find the conclusion of it. I was curious to learn about germs and bacteria, so then I started reading books about them, so I could learn more. At the end, I came up with a detailed presentation.
Inquiry-based learning, when I did the Maya research project. And another example is when we did the research about the systems of the human body.
Most of the activities in fifth grade started with a question. The part that I love the most is that we were creating something like posters, slides, presentation logos, and even bread. On one IPC unit while learning, we helped others in the meantime. We collected food for the homeless. We are researching things that interest us most.
I applied inquiry-based learning when we were learning about atoms. I was having trouble, and then when we got the computers from the school, I researched by myself, and then I learned how to do it, and I didn't have trouble at all. And my favorite part of inquiry-based learning was when I was having trouble with math for dividing decimals, and I researched by myself and I understood it. I was having trouble and I was telling myself in my mind, aha, inquiry-based learning. Then I focused and researched everything and I understood.
Well, my favorite project was when we had to come up with a question with a whole group, and everybody did one question and then we had to answer it. Like mine was, how are heart attacks caused?
First of all, my favorite inquiry-based learning project was me with my friend Talon, about how we talked from how long the travel distance is from Skopje to Amsterdam and where we could stop. And before we did all these projects, we actually researched and read books and did all the other stuff. And later, after the whole project, we even had a presentation and I really liked it because you could do it with your friend, and I was lucky to do it with my Dutch friend because we're both Dutch, and yeah.
Hi everyone, I just wanted to say that this was one of the best years of my life. Being in fifth grade taught me a lot of things. It taught me, first it taught me the importance of friendship. It also taught me to be able to work in a team, and I'm very grateful for everything. Ms. Babbage and the whole class, thank you for an amazing year.
Inquiry-based learning is when we learn based on our own questions and curiosity. Then we find out the answers through research and our experiments. My favorite part in this year of inquiry-based learning was in our unit Bake It, when we had a lot of experiments with food, and they were all based on our curiosity and questions.
Ms. Babbage helped us accomplish inquiry-based learning. At first she helped us, then we could do it by ourselves. Inquiry learning always starts with an open-ended question, which we later on find the answer to. We research and use different kinds of sources. I'd say my favorite inquiry-based question was, why should or shouldn't cloning be legal? From the Being Human unit. This past year with Ms. Babbage has been full of new discoveries. Ms. Babbage is the best teacher, and we all love her.
Congratulations on finishing fifth grade, the last year of elementary school. I wish you the best as you start the next chapter of middle school next school year. So, the school year didn't end the way that we expected, but there were still lots of opportunities for us to perform acts of kindness and show empathy towards others. Recently, a study came out suggesting that performing acts of kindness towards others boosts our own happiness. It's because it helps us be aware of things in our own lives that we have to be thankful for. But in addition to this, the world needs more empathy and kindness. So as you reflect on fifth grade and our year together, what act of kindness stands out that you did towards someone else, or what act of kindness did someone show towards you this year?
Oh, yeah. If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll tell the world to find you. And if you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light there to guide you. We find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3. I'll be there, 'cause I know when I need it, I can count on you. Like 4, 3, 2. You'll be there, 'cause that's what friends are supposed to do. Oh yeah. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah. If you're tossing and you're turning and you just can't fall asleep, I'll sing a song beside you. And if you ever forget how much you really mean to me, every day I will remind you.
People in need was I made posters for people to bring in food, and I donated lentils and rice. I also made muffins for them to have a sweet treat.
For about fifth grade is Retweet a Meal Food Drive, because it made me feel good. And another project that Thrive J worked on was a food drive for an animal shelter. Both projects made me feel good and made me have good adventures.
Hello, today I want to talk about two things. The first is about the teacher, Maria, who helped me to master English at the beginning of the year and who helped me to feel welcome at the beginning of the year. And the other thing is my friend Sano, who I met at the beginning of the year. And with him, when I was playing, it was a lot of fun for me.
My favorite act of empathy that I will remember about this year will be my parents helping me through hard times during the school year.
I acted toward one of my friends with empathy. I helped her by being nice to her. We were talking on the phone and my friend felt left out because she remembered a very sad thing that happened in her past, and I could see that she was sad by her attitude. I made her feel better by making her laugh and empathizing with her.
act of kindness I did is when we baked bread and gave it to the homeless for a retweet meal.
The thing that I will remember most of act of kindness from fifth grade is when someone stole something from my friend, and I helped my friend find out like evidence to prove that that person stole it and to prove it to the teacher.
When my friend felt left out, I could see she felt sad. First, I made sure she trusted me and told what happened to her. Then I tried connecting with her pain and understanding what might she be feeling. I also tried making her laugh so she could forget that moment, but when she wasn't fully happy, I told her how I was going through this and how to forget that moment.
So one of my friends used to always help me in Macedonian class and was always being like kind to me whenever I was like having a hard time, or even in some like times where I didn't understand like subjects from other classes, he used to always help me. So yeah, he was having kindness towards me.
I haven't done a lot of acts of kindness. Most of them have been really small and I probably won't remember many of them. Probably the only thing I'll remember is that I've helped a lot of my friends with homework. Most of the time, they're having a lot of trouble, and I'm usually the one that helps them.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mia Yusupi, and I'm going to be telling you a story of how I show true act of kindness. The story I'd like to tell you today is how me and my friends were really sad that in a year, almost all of us would be probably in separate classes. And I was the one who sent positive activity outside, because even though we're going to be in different classes, we're still always going to be best friends.
Since my past years in middle school, I've made a lot of friends, but I have some of them that are special to me. They helped me with my homework or to learn my lesson. That's why I really appreciate to be friends with them.
Hi everyone, my name is Jovana Rangelovic. I joined Nova this school year, and I have to say that it's the best thing that ever happened to me. Among other interesting things, this school year we did many acts of kindness that I will always remember. One of them was when we had the Bake It unit, and we were baking bread for the shelters for the poor people.
The act of kindness that I remember most from fifth grade is being quote unquote accepted on the first day and even before that. Like when I came to look at the school, a few people were already there, and Ellie Kate showed me where the dance room was, and we had a nice conversation, and Arella toured the entire playground for me on the first day of school and even introduced me to some of her friends.
So I acted kindly when I was asked to read a friend's story. The story was about her losing her dog. She mentioned in the story how upset she was after and how nowadays she is still a bit upset and misses him so much. So I comforted her and told her that this type of stuff happens and that her dog is still in a better place right now.
The kindest thing that anyone has ever done to me in fifth grade is after my surgery, I came back to school. Everyone was happy, especially Martin, Ivan, and Yuz. They came up to the door and showered me with affection and empathy.
The acts of kindness I've acted on someone is when me and Table 3 had a meeting about our presentations, and when the presentation ended, I gave compliments on their essays and they gave compliments on my essay. So that was really good about giving compliments about someone's essay.
The biggest act of kindness that someone acted to me was when I first came to fifth grade and I was lonely and I didn't know the school. So there were three girls, Daniela, Jovana R, and Leia, that were in the same situation. They were also new. And we met and we became friends.
I am very grateful with this year how my teacher, Ms. Jensen, helped me with my assignments and when I needed help from her, She was always there to help me.
Hello everyone! Welcome to our moving up ceremony. Today is the day that we celebrate our 5th grade classes as they move from elementary to middle school. Our students learn and have grown so much this year. They learn about their strengths as individuals, about new skills, and discover themselves and others. Skills such as communication and cooperation, kindness, empathy, and inquiry were integrated throughout this year. Students learned that these skills gave them the chance to learn from each other while gaining crucial skills. Throughout cooperative learning, they have learned how to cooperate, how to work in teams, and have other individuals depending on them. By working together, they learn how to trust each other so they can achieve a common goal. They were exposed to different types of knowledge and widen their horizons. Students became better listeners and decision makers. Grade 5, congratulations to everyone. We will miss you and we wish you luck.
Oh, yeah. If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll tell the world to find you. And if you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light there to guide you. We find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3. I'll be there.
Firstly, we have been using Google Meets to collaborate with my teachers and students. It's basically an online class for everyone around the world. Secondly, we have Google things like Google Slides and Google Docs and Classroom to prepare our presentations and assignments. And lastly, We have many different ways to cooperate, like Google Chats and Viber and WhatsApp. My conclusion is, in these past 2 months or so, my experience in online learning has taught me to be a better self-learner and has given me the opportunity to learn better techniques of school.
So I think that by cooperating and communicating, you should help everyone you see. And communication is when people exchange their thoughts and ideas with one another. Cooperation is when you're working together at the same end. By cooperating and communicating, you can have more teamwork, active listening, and positive feedback. So my communication and cooperation helped me develop into a more successful learner.
I think my cooperation and communication skills have helped me a lot this year, especially because we've done a lot of group projects this year, and I've worked a lot with my friends, especially one time when we were working on a project about geography. I thought like I knew everything and I could just do the whole project by myself. But then afterwards, I realized that my friends know a lot too, and so we worked together, and the presentation ended up being really well.
My communication and cooperation skills helped me become a more successful learner by listening to everyone's ideas, teamwork, less demanding, and being sociable. And when you work alone, it's okay, but as my mom says, two heads are better than one, which means one idea is great, but two together is even better.
Since my first day at Nova, I have changed my communication skills to higher level. When I first came here, I was shy and my English wasn't good enough. As time passed, I was doing a lot of work in school, reading and writing, and now I am comfortable to say that I have developed better vocabulary.
Effective communication with all my teachers made me be aware of many things, such as thinking in a first line, but also makes me convenient in my reading, writing, and of course, talking. The communication conveys information, but not only that it stimulates, it delivers quickly and accurately.
Even if we don't go to school, we still communicate online. We still cooperate by working in teams. We learn everything online. Even if we are not going to school, we finish our homework, schoolwork, in time.
I think that my communication and cooperation skills help me develop into a successful learner by making me communicate easily and work in a group. An example of this are the IPC exit points. In each lesson, we have different groups and projects in which these skills help me work with different people and their character stage. The communication helped me talk about my ideas, and the cooperation helped me understand their ideas and work with them.
This is my graduation video, and I will show you how cooperation and communication have helped me throughout the year. They've helped me by making a lot of new friends, making myself a better person, and being able to understand their feelings. Cooperation has helped me by talking to people. I've understood what they feel in arguments and what I should do to help them.
I've become a better learner by asking questions when I didn't understand. I also learned how to communicate with presentations for different subjects. We did a lot of work and projects together in groups. I felt these skills growing this year. I'm glad to be able to communicate and cooperate with family, friends, and other people in my life.
Communication and cooperation are two very important skills. Communication is when you talk to a person, and cooperation is when you work together to achieve a common goal. I have learned that communication is not only knowing how to express yourself, it is also knowing how to listen to people respectfully. Cooperation is one of the most important skills to have. It has helped me become a better learner because every time I cooperate with somebody, I learn something new.
My cooperation skills make teamwork easier and doing things with others easy as well. I really like the fact that my communication and cooperation skills make me a better learner, and I can't wait to go to sixth grade.
I feel my communication and cooperation skills have helped me develop into a better learner because I have been able to communicate with many of my friends through phone calls. We have many group projects, and of course we have, through communication, we have been developed a better team chemistry, and I have been able to be a lot more engaged than in the group projects, and I feel that's how I've become into a more successful learner.
Whenever I have something that I don't understand, I discuss it with my friends, teammates, or teacher, making it clearer for all of us.
This year I'm gonna finish fifth grade. My teachers were Miss Maya and Miss Maria. First, when I came to the school, it was a little bit scary, but the communication and cooperation helped me be more comfortable in the school and be a better student.
I feel my communication and cooperation skills have helped me develop into a better learner by helping me see other people's point of view and keeping an open mind while doing so.
Communication and cooperation helped me communicate with my classmates and with other kids that go in Nova. Also, first I was nervous, but now I'm actually excited to go and learn new things with my friends.
My answer is, I can say that I learned more when I was communicating with my classmates and we all shared an opinion about that topic. I remember the ideas we shared and the conclusions we reached, and even more, it made me go even deeper into that topic.
I think that I'm a better learner because I feel more helpful, I feel more important when doing a project, I share my ideas with my teammates, I listen to theirs, and I've definitely learned more cooperative skills. So that is why I'm proud of what I have achieved.
I hear it calling out.
Congratulate our fifth graders. They're coming to an end of one part of a journey and at the beginning of a much larger one. It is filled with challenges, but my dear fifth graders, you have the resilience and your knowledge, skills and understanding with you. You have so many academic achievements so far, and you have grown socially and emotionally, overcoming many obstacles, including this COVID-19 pandemic. I want you to stay curious, be kind human beings, and never stop dreaming. Your MYP teachers will be very lucky to have you, and we are all so very proud of you. And now, let me officially promote you to middle school. Miss Jensen's class. Mina Alkarbuli. Jakša Babić. Lea Bachmeier. Aurela Besimi. Jovana Vlaževa. Kaan Tanovski. Hari Dostinov Atanasovski. Eva Gorbok. Jagis Bulju. Martin Jovanovski. Mija Jusufi. Ivan Stanislavov Kaslijovski. Jovan Rangelović. Ema Salonga. Mija Timoti. Andrej Todorov Bo. Marko Trajkovski. Sara Visotska. Saša Zdravevska. Miss Babić's class. Furkan Balaban. Faton Berg. Damjan Dojčinovski. Sara Gorbok. Logan Dimitri Hazler. Amin Jakovski. Elena Janma. Max Jonovski. Ilija Kamče. Mila Kamcheva, Alexei Postovsky, Andrei Marinovsky, Vladimir Nikolic, Joanna Nikolovska, Matej Pechčevski, Jakob Romih, Milo Simon, Mia Stankovic, Nadia Taskova, Miss Slavkovska's class, Roda Almahmu, Vedran Andonovski, Kostadina Arabadji, Nicholas Arabadji, Angelina Buleska, Elikei Batmir, Sanel Čolović, Marin Dimitrovski, Daniela Gorbo, Hana Hadžija, Mateja Joveva, Leo Yusufi, Lana Lam, Filip Lazarević Kamčev, Ivan Nikolovski, Sara Pandeleska, Andrej Pechčevski, Kalina Redel, Bojan Simev Milkovski,